You guys can already hear me. Let me just mentally prepare for this stream. Needs a lot of it. Needs a lot of preparation mentally.
You guys can already hear me. Let me just mentally prepare for this stream. Needs a lot of it. Needs a lot of preparation mentally.
Yes. Sound already works. It's important for sound to work in this interesting stream. Yeah. You know what would be funny if we just skip the timer? I think that would be good. You know, that would be quite a bit of a troll kind of thing. Just skips the timer. Should we do that? I think we should do that. I think that's a good idea. All right. Let me get everything ready here. Okay. Maybe we can start like 1 minute early. That could be funny. Okay. All right. Starting like 36 seconds early. Let's go. Welcome back, everybody, to the channel. Another live stream. Are you guys seeing me? Are you guys hearing me? I hope you guys are doing very well. Welcome back. Welcome back. What great time it is to stream again. A little bit of an unusual time, or in general, it's a little bit unusual for me to stream in general because I haven't been streaming a lot recently. And my goal for this week at least, or, you know, for the near future, is to stream a little bit more. And you know what? What nice way is there to start streaming again? There's a house here. Come on, I just want to see the plane that we're going to be flying today, because today's stream is going to be very interesting and experimental. What's up, the 169027? Welcome back. Long time no see. It's great to have you here from Hong Kong, my guy. Yes, everybody. You can see what plane we're going to be flying today, and you can definitely tell that by the title as well. We're going to do an interesting flight on board the F-35. See, you know, I've never actually properly flown a fighter jet on the streams at all. And I thought today, you know what? We've got to change that. In today's stream that we're going to be doing, let's go ahead and do a full flight in an F-35, which could be interesting. And well, let's just go ahead and start this here. Ready to fly. Yes, everybody, welcome back on board the F-35. Can we? Yes, we can hear some. Literally, we're not even 5 seconds into the flight. There's already someone spawned into us, but that's just great to see. Yes, welcome. We can hear some birds, which is interesting because it's in the winter of the Alpine Mountains. Yes, we're in the Alpine Mountains again. And there are no birds in the winter. There are some birds here, but Jesus Christ. Anyway, enough of messing around. We're on board this plane, obviously, the F-35. I reviewed this interesting add-on very recently, very recent release, indeed. And today's video, let's go ahead and fly this interesting aeroplane around. Of course, this is the F-35B. If you guys know this plane, the F-35B is the variant that can do the VTOL takeoff, pretty much takeoff, floating, technically. Actually, the thing is, I mentioned that in the video I made about this plane recently. Actually, this plane wasn't ever designed to take off and land. Vertically. It still needs a runway. You know what? It still has, you know, those short takeoff modes. So in today's video, I picked some interesting airports to fly this plane to. As we can tell, yes, we're in the Alpine Mountains. And this is going to be a very fun time that we're going to have today because, you know, we've got, you know, the classics. We've got, first of all, Alpe de Huez Airport, which has a 400-meter-long runway literally on a mountain. I mean, it's asphalt, though. And then, of course, we have Méribel Airport here in the Alpine Mountains. And, of course, our good old friend Courchevel. A lot of interesting airport. This is now Megève Airport, as far as I can remember. Very interesting ones. We have Oste, I think, which is a bit of a longer runway. But other than that, very short runways here in on pretty much... Most of the time, most of these airports are actually in the French Alpine Mountains. So yes, a full flight to those places. And I think we're going to be very, very much able to fly this plane today. What, of course, I have no idea about is how to fly an F-35. So you guys probably might have to guide me through this. I have never done a full flight on any fighter jet at all. So I'm very inexperienced when it comes to this. And the problem is that this add-on here is super realistic. This is going to be very fun. And we've got a very professional donation right here.
Just нижнее подчеркивание трейдинг донатет 2 британских фунта стерлингов и...
I've just remembered, if you guys tuned into yesterday's stream, we changed the donation voice to Russian. Should we go back to like a language that speaks somewhat English? Sorry, let's switch it back. What accent should we go to? I mean, we have several to choose from, of course. I might just want to set that before we begin here with this proper stream. We have Russian, of course, which we're changed to right now. Let me try. I mean, we've got... We've got US, we've got India. We had Indian for a long, long time. We might just want to try out a Welsh accent. How about that? We've got Jaren from Wales, who's going to read our donations now. So, alert box updated. So, yes, and if anyone donates, it'll be read out in a Welsh accent. I think that could be fun. Yeah, the Indian accent was quite legendary. The voice, her name was Aditi, by the way. So yes, anyway, let's go ahead and start up this plane finally. This is a little bit more simplistic than older fighter jets. Of course, this F-35 is quite modern, but we might just want to try this out. So how do we do this? How do we turn this plane on? I have no idea. This is like literally the first time ever trying this.
Jenna donated €2. Moin Meister.
Moin Meister! Yes. Moin Meister indeed. Let's maybe close this canopy. That's the only lever I already know. With this very weird and buggy animation. Anyway, good. So how do we get this started up? I seriously have no idea about this. I mean, those are like literally the only... Ah, there we go. Battery switch. Good. Let's turn this to normal. Integrated power plan master switch. That could probably be a good idea. The inverter converter. Maybe that is a good idea. Good. Master turned on. Yeah, I think, you know, these, of course, you know, these fighter jets, they are designed to, you know, be able to be taken off very quickly. Not a lot of setup time. Those are designed to, you know, be able to go off immediately in an emergency or something like that. But how do I get this to work? Backup. This is the master arm switch, which is the arm. I have no idea about this aeroplane. I just wanted to mention that right here. We've got a Remupi for flight sticker here. Maybe I just want to could use that. What does that do even? I don't know. It says been removed before flight, so I've just removed it. That's probably a good idea. Welcome back to Swiss is everyone. But anyway, we can hear a noise. First of all, that's good. How do I turn on? I don't even know. Engine page. I'm gonna go to the engine page. Engine. How do I start this up? All right, stand by. I'll do. What's up, Andy? From Hong Kong. Thank you very much. I'm confusion. What's up, Dylan? From Myanmar? Is that Myanmar? Welcome back. You guys are very much appreciated. Thank you guys so much. And I still don't know how to turn this plane on. I need help. All right, we've got an engine start switch right here. I guess this is the ignition switch. Turned on. Will that already start up the engines? Yes! Good. You know what? We're looking pretty good here. Of course, again, pretty simplistic plane. It's designed to be, you know, somewhat simple. No need to make it hard to fly. Here we go. We've got the N2 RPM coming up. So we should already probably see some spinach here in the outside model. Well, I mean, we could see it if there wasn't a fucking house in front of it. I mean, behind. Oh, there we go. Yes, spinach. We've got spinach indeed. Yes, everybody. You know, this is gonna be a very good flight today. Good. Yes, everybody, welcome back. This is just a great flight. Good. Some water, very important. You know, it's important to stay hydrated. By the way, I do want to start a little bit of a poll right here, or a bit of a survey. Should we have the snow turned on? Because I hate snow in the flight simulator. I mean, it looks good, but I just hate it. Because, I mean, by the way, the engine is perfectly starting up, by the way. I just wanted to mention that as well. I'm very proud of that. My God, I wouldn't have thought this would be so easy. Good! So let's go ahead and everything's fine. Should we leave the snow turned on? Because the thing is, what I hate about the flight simulator in general is that whenever there's snow, it literally covers the runway. I mean, who the hell had the idea? All right, okay, you know what? We're gonna simulate this very nice snow thing, which, you know, does work quite well, but who had the idea to cover the runways? I mean, that's not how it works in real life at all. We can't even, it's just a white, I mean, we can barely tell it. But that's not how it works in real life. Somebody's just gonna turn off the snow, my God. All right, life weather turned off. Yes, it looks much better, doesn't it? Good, so, how do we, let's have some, there we go, perfect. Oh, what's up? Hope you don't crash today. We won't crash. What's up, from India, Krutha, thank you so much. Hey guys, we've got the whole world here. Thank you guys so much. You guys are so appreciated. But anyway, now it's time to get flying, I guess. This is going to be very nice. Keep the snow on? No, we're going to keep the snow off now. Let's see if the, its afterburner works nicely. We've turned on the aeroplane. This has been fairly simple. Let's go ahead now. I do have, again, the F-35B, which would allow us to actually take off on the spot vertically, but we're not going to do that because that's not how the plane works in real life. So, let's go ahead nicely, as always. What's up, the 169er?
The 16,927 donated 16.
That's how you can pronounce
dollars.
It as well.
I hope you don't crash today.
I hope we won't. The thing is, right, I mean, I mentioned this in the video I made about this interesting aeroplane. We don't have an ejection seat right here. I mean, we do have it, at least animated here, but we cannot press it. So we cannot, you know, jump out of the aeroplane. We cannot do a literal, I mean, this would be a literal kind of, what's it called? What's this guy called again? Trevor Jacob thing. We cannot do that. So, we're not able to do that kind of thing. So we cannot eject ourselves. Sorry about the FPS. We cannot eject ourselves. You know, it's like the funny thing. In these butter landing videos, I always complain about people that have low FPS, but I'm literally the person that has lowest FPS here, I think. I do have, like, this RTX 3080, though, so I'm a little bit disappointed in that. All right, anyway. Now, we're on this runway, and I do have to say, this plane is literally, this has been the best taxi experience I've had ever. Damn, this plane taxis so smoothly. My God, I like that. All right. Let's go ahead and hop into this little bit of a vertical flight mode. What's it called? Exerc. How do I do this? Ah, there we go. Now, this is like the stovel mode. We can turn... No, I don't want this turned into hover mode. I want this in... Like, I can press these... It's not worked! The whole flight simulator crashed! Thank you, Puncake, by the way. Shut up! The game is already running, you just crashed! Alright, that's like the thing. Like a big problem that a lot of people reported about this F-35 add-on plane that it just keeps crashing all the time. Here it is, F-35 Lightning. It does have some good reviews, but there are some bad ones here as well. Michael, many CTDs. To those who don't know what a CTD is, it does sound like a little bit of like a sexually transmitted disease, but it means that it crashed your desktop, and we do experience that here as well. It just crashed here in front of almost 1,000 people. The whole thing, it looked so beautiful. That was the most disappointing thing I've ever seen in my life. I'm about to cry. What's up, Virulet? Also from Hong Kong. We've got a lot of Hong Kong
Virulet
these people.
Virulet donated 25 Hong Kong dollars. Hey, Swiss 001. Do not judge, but would you recommend X-Plane 11 on keyboard and mouse or any other flight simulators? Thank you.
I mean, you could fly like Airbus planes that literally fly themselves. That could be an option very late. But I would recommend buying a joystick. I mean, there are some cheap joysticks out there. I mean, we can have a quick look. I mean, joystick. We can have a little bit of a shopping spree right here while the whole flight simulator has to reload after it completely crashed in this F-35. Everything looks so beautiful. All right, this is like a very nice little joystick right here. Mind Factory. What an interesting sight. That's not a joystick.
Endo Butters donated 5 Swiss francs.
What has this been?
Lol, RTX 3080 can't help you now.
Yeah, no, this is like the thing. Alright, that's interesting. Whole flight simulator is just black. This is the worst stream ever. It started so well. But it's just going downhill. My God, it's like another thing about the flight simulator. Why does it have to load for literally 20,000 hours? My God, but let's go back, you know, to this fast. All right, my mouse stopped working. Why is everything going downhill indeed? All right, here we go, it's back. All right, let's go back to shopping. Interesting joystick here that I've searched up for you. Yeah,
Victor,
come on.
Pro Gaming donated 45 Danish krona. I love your videos, you're the best YouTuber.
Thank you, man. Very much appreciated. We've got an interesting joystick here. I searched up for a joystick and this comes up. They're all Cytec. I do have one of those as well. But here we go. Let's check this out again. Mind Factory. What if I'm pressing on the joystick. Literally nothing is working. I'm pressing on this joystick. The Logitech. I can very much recommend the Logitech project as well. But here we go. Pressing on it will give you this. What a nice Logitech joystick. I hate this thing. Anyway, you know, there are some expensive joysticks out there, but even this, you know, kind of a entry-level Thrustmaster joystick will do a great job, actually. So yes, just invest a little bit of money. I mean, $36 really isn't much. But you know what? Thrustmaster is a great partner. You know, they've always... I've got to say, a little bit of a shout-out there. I mean, I'm using a Thrustmaster joystick right now. I can very much recommend those. You know... Again, this is so much better. This will give you so much of a better experience than using like mouse yoke or a keyboard, right? Please use a mouse. Please use a joystick. All right, that's on the part while the flight simulator is loading for literally 20,000 hours. But yeah, back to the whole problem that we're left with. By the way, if you guys just tuned in, what happened here is what's up, Jonathan? Thank you guys so much. You guys are so appreciated. But yeah. The problem was here, we spawned into the F-35, everything was looking nice. I was literally tuning up the engines to full power, about to take off on the runway, very nice startup. And then the whole thing just crashed. Which is a general problem of the F-35. I mean, we can see that here in the ratings. I've already done a video on this with the issues here, Michael. Many CTDs, again, crash to desktops. The thing just likes to crash. CTD within 30 minutes. I guess this is not the first time or not the last time especially that we're going to see a crash in today's video. So let's go ahead and spawn back into this F-35B. Maybe like make this quick. Let's spawn into Courchevel already. You know what? I'm already in for the challenge. All right? Let's try this.
Very donated 25 Hong Kong dollars. Thank you for your recommendation. I know this is such a bad timing for a donation, but thank you for providing me entertainment since the pandemic.
There's never a bad time for a donation. Oh, my light has just died. My background light. It's all just dark here. But thank you guys so much. A lot of Hong Kong people here. What's up, Martix as well? How's it going?
Martix donated $4.70. Hello, Swiss. Some info. Do not use Afterburner on longer routes BCS fuel. And you can do a full VTOL takeoff or landing. Google it.
What the hell here? Why are we spawned in midair?
Andy Chung donated 25 Hong Kong dollars. I crashed my game Trevor 01.
Yeah, dude. I mean, literally, I wasn't the one who crashed it. This was never intentional. The whole flight simulator just decided to die. But let me just try to spawn again here into Le Courchevel Airport. My goodness, what a stream this is. Luckily, no one was injured. Yeah. How did you just pronounce injured? Injured. That could be another word. Yeah, I mean, I do have to say, we do have to probably write a review after this here. The whole plane just crashed in front of 1,000 people here. Great. So yes, there's a little bit of Switzerland. What happened in the stream? What's up? First Cope from Switzerland then.
First Cope donated 5 Swiss francs. Hey Swiss, genuine question, how much did you spend for your flight training? I am really looking forward to be a pilot one day, but stuff is expensive.
It is. I spent a lot of money on it. Actually, so much that I don't really want to talk a little about it because it's so embarrassing. Embarrassingly much. There's ways to do cheap flight training. When you do a private pilot license, you can do it for around $10,000. Depending on where you do it, there are, you know, especially in the US, it's a lot cheaper, but I suggest that you live in Switzerland, so it's going to be a lot more expensive, I would guess. But, yeah.
Reptis donated $3.90.
Singapore! How's it going, man?
Hello, Swiss HHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHH
stream our own way. Yes, anyway, it's now time. You know what? Let's give this plane a little bit of another chance, right? We're now spawned into a fresh F-35B. Okay, everything's looking good. I've just turned on the battery master. This plane, as we found out here in our first try, before the whole plane crashed in front of 1,000 people, because it likes to do that, apparently. Yeah, there's a... I'm pretty sure we're going to see another crash in this video, in this stream. This is going to be super interesting. But yeah, before the whole plane decided to die in front of 1,000 people, we found out that this plane is actually quite easy to start up. You know, as it's supposed to be. You know, it's... Good stream. I like how this is just all falling apart here. This is... what does this stream do? I like how this microphone... I mean, it's fallen down so much over the streams. But I like how it's still alive, this microphone. I mean, look at this motivation that this microphone has. What's up, Rip This? Look at this.
Rip This donated $3.86.
What's up?
Yes, hello, greetings from Singapore.
Greetings back to Singapore. You know, this microphone is still going strong. This is a Shure SM7B, and these were literally designed to... This is going to last me like 20 more years, I'm pretty sure. Because, you know, this is an awesome mic. Ah! Let me just set this up right here while the airplane is starting up, by the way, in the background. What a great stream this is. A lot of people watching right here. Literally everything is falling apart. A little bit of a sit rep. What have we been doing for the last 30 minutes? Literally trying to start up the F-35, which actually has worked quite well. Let me actually turn on the ignition right here while I'm trying to set up the microphone. Here we go. Engine ignition switch.
First Cope donated 2 Swiss francs. Don't break everything.
Dude, I'm not trying to. Literally everything is falling apart on itself. I don't even have to do anything to... for everything to break. Literally everything is falling apart on its own. I don't know how. The flight simulator is gonna crash probably like a few thousand times in the stream. Again, trying to get the microphone to work. Everything's fine. Just don't worry. Don't worry about it. Come on. There we go. As long as someone holds, it holds. Yeah, that's good. That's good. I just want to fly this plane now. We've been streaming for half an hour. We haven't done a single feet of altitude, right? Because the whole thing is just broken. It's all stream. Welcome back, Swiss01. There's a lot of people watching today, right? And so it's time to be professional now. Plane is starting up nicely as it should. Again, pretty easy plane to start up. Literally only a few switches, as it's designed to do, again, to quickly, in an emergency, react and fly out. What's up, Martix, again? Thank you so much.
Martix donated $4.70. And please turn on the in-helmet HUD. It's the first switch on right under the display.
Helmet HUD. Where is that? First switch under the display. Where? Where? There's no switch here. No idea. Helmet
Reku
HUD.
Reku donated $2.99. I live in your walls. Smiley face.
I mean, I know that's just probably what Australians are like. Okay,
let's
go and fly.
2 Swiss francs.
What's up?
Will you ever do a live in your SR-22?
I don't know if even that's possible. I mean, you don't have any mobile data up there. But there we go. Let's go ahead and actually fly this plane finally. My good. We're here at Courchevel, right? The only way we're going to probably get this plane off the ground here is by, well, going into this half VTOL mode again. So let's try to press this button on the joystick. Come on. Work! There we go. Stovel mode. Let's go ahead and put this into like this
Rick
half.
Rick has donated $3.86.
What's up?
A350 stream when?
Oh, I have streamed the A350 before. It was a lot of fun. Anyway, let's go ahead and fly this.
Mango
What's
man
up, Mango Man?
22 Norwegian kroner. What MSFS server are you on?
I'm on the North European... Stop donating! I want to talk! North European server. I'm sorry. What's up,
Lisa? Donated 25 Polish zlotys.
How's it going, you guys?
I just wanted to say thank you for cheering me up in 2021. You're almost
no problem, dude.
A friend for me, lol.
Oh, thanks you guys so much. You guys are so kind, even though the stream just sucks.
Tiger Krausen donated $2. Thanks for your videos.
Thank you. Stop being so kind. Literally, we suck. All right, great. Let's go ahead and fly.
Martix donated $2.33. That BRT thing under the display.
The BRT thing? Ah. Aha. Does it work? It doesn't work. Doesn't do anything. Doesn't do anything at all. That's just great to see. Please. All right, anyway. It's time to fly, finally. We are finally here on the runway. Let's give it full power. See if this is going to work. We've got a lot of warnings here, a lot of caution on the display, but we're just going to take off. Oh, my God! Yes! Again, we're in this kind of half VTOL, half stall mode, and that's worked very nicely. Holy moly, let's go back into the normal mode. Yes? Yes! Oh my God, I like this aeroplane. That's been perfect. What's up, Dylan? Thank you so much. You guys are crazy. Good. We've got a lot of warnings on our display, but what is important is that our plane flies, which it still does, so that's good. Let's go ahead and put the flaps up. Hey, that's been good. Let's give it full power. The afterburner doesn't work, which is weird. Why doesn't it work? It should work. Why isn't it working? Anyway, that doesn't matter. We're literally flying. We're flying an F-35, and we're already super fast, almost at, well, supersonic speeds, basically. I want to, of course, we've got a first destination here ahead, which is the airport of Mijev. Let's try to pull up the map. Is that possible? Yes. So we've got the LFKX airport. Very, you know, these are two airports that are in very close proximity. Let's go ahead and try. This is actually looking very good. All right, so we've got that airport, the Meribel airport, or I think it's Mijev. I don't know what it's called. It doesn't really matter. We've got the airport here. You can probably see the runway. It's very tiny. You know, without the whole usage of the Stovel mode or whatever it's called again, we would probably be doomed. But luckily, we have this mode where we can... Come on, turn it on. Turn on, you stupid plane! Come on. Can we go into the Stovel mode? Or are we too fast for that? We are a little bit fast, aren't we? Let's put the landing gear down to slow down a little
donated
bit. Come on.
$70 Taiwan.
So what's up,
Hello
Ebelin?
Hello there.
Dude, Ebelin, congratulations again to 100,000 subscribers, dude. You've got 100,000 now. Well, I'm trying to fly this plane right now. Don't mind me. Oh, my God. Let's calm down. Very professional flight. I'm just trying to turn on the stubble mode. Why hasn't that worked? Come on. Stubble? Yes. Why are we literally stalling out? We're at 170 knots. That shouldn't happen. Good! Now, we're back in our stubble mode. Let's go. Good. Now we're in this half mode where we can fly very
Smelly
slowly.
Smelly Smells donated €4.99.
How's it
what
going?
Is your favorite airport?
My favorite airport? Dude, that's an interesting question. I don't even know how to answer that. I don't know. What's my favorite airport? I don't know. What's my favorite airport? LaGuardia. All right, everybody, let's go ahead and now land. Please. This plane is so weird to fly, honestly, in this mode especially. So we've just, as you can see, we're in this kind of half vertical flying mode, and it's very weird how the plane flies. Why does it like bang to the right this much? Like, it's a little bit broken, isn't it? Why does it do this? All right, let's put the landing gear down, by the way. Is that possible? Yes. Oh, this is going to be such a crash. Let's go into the full This is a very bad flight, I've just noticed. Why is it broken? What is going on here? That makes no sense physically. Interesting flight model. Quite magic. Welcome back to Military 001, the first time ever flying this F-35 properly. I like how it literally can fly like this. Awesome. But you know what, I do want to use a little bit of slew mode right here. I just want to land this plane here on Mjev's runway. Okay, good. Welcome back to professionally flying the F-35 with Swiss 001. Isn't this like a how much is this plane? Can anyone post a number of the pricing of this plane? It was, as far as I remember, the development, at least, of this aeroplane was ridiculously expensive. Because, you know, there was a few issues. What I can see is it still has a few issues. Why did it bank to the right? I'm literally fully banking into the left. Maybe that's because we have so many warnings here on our display, and this plane is just completely broken. Let's maybe try to do this. Come on. Okay, plane costs $130 million. Which is a good price. I mean, that's... Alright, you know what? I expected it to cost a little bit more. At least, how about... Oh, damn! We have played through physics, everybody! That is exactly how the F-35 flies in real life. You know what? Welcome back. Is that true that the F-35 can literally fly upside down in this double mode? Because that wouldn't really make any sense at all. Welcome back to physics. We have played through the physics, everybody. Okay, interesting. So can we land? I want to land upside down. All right, you know what? I mean, I do have to say, I rated this plane quite well in the review video I did on it, in this add-on airplane, but I'm kind of doubting the realism of this plane now. I can literally fly upside down. What's up, the
16,927 donated.
Damn,
60 Hong Kong dollars.
One.
Whoop, whoop, terrain, pull up.
Great! Yeah, no, this is not at all how the plane would fly in real life, of course, right? I mean, you know, it has this this engine which is flipped so that it, you know, delivers this the lift, which is, you know, wouldn't work upside down, obviously. It's kind of like a helicopter trying to fly upside down. Wouldn't work either. Oh, okay, someone is commenting that the plane is just in an Australian mode. Okay, that would make sense. Is any Australian watching? Probably going to be late in the night in Australia, isn't it? So yeah, great physics out here. So can we get this plane landed, please? It's just not working at all. The funny thing, I don't even know why. Am I doing something wrong? Because, okay, again, trying to fly this plane seriously now, I have zero control of this plane. Like, it's weird. It's broken in general. I mean, look at the display here. Look at the vertical. The artificial horizon right here. It's just stuck. So I'm guessing the plane is just broken. That could be. In general, why do I have these banking issues? Like, look, when I let go of the control, this is what happens. And I cannot, why is it doing this? Why is this broken? Interesting. All right, let's maybe try to get this plane landed now properly. We've got the runway in front of us, let's maybe do this.
Sub 124 donated €5. Hi. Sub. Letzten Zabaik minor booster impfung bekommen und jetzt habe ich hier ein WLAN, Welches mRNA impf chip _ AZ7543 28429
PET. It still flies!
We get us weg.
Booster vaccination. Of course I'm jabbed as well. I recently received my third vaccination as well, and I would recommend that you do as well too. And I've just noticed, I mean, there are some good benefits to it. Ever since I've been vaccinated, I've got the 5G network. I'm literally on 5G right now, so that's a bonus point. You know, I've gotten a few percentages off my Microsoft Excel subscriptions. So that's a good thing. What's up, Martin?
Martix donated $2.33. Right. I think that you should try the X-Plane version again after this.
Yeah. Dude, I mean, there is literally so much better of a version for X-Plane of the F-35. All right, anyway, we're just taking off here without the VTOL mode. I guess in this video, we might just want to try not using that. What's up, Christopher Dumming?
Christopher Dumming donated $5.
Good morning.
Moin aus Niedersachsen, Nick Wunschadier, Nick Heinenschen, and Sontag.
Never mind, not from the USA. Aus Niedersachs. Aus Germanland. Why would you donate in dollars, though? That's weird. Welcome back to Swiss Missouri 1. Yes, everybody. Welcome back to physics. So, good. This is, interesting. Yeah, again, we've just hit the state of hyper. I've lost my ability to speak. I'm having a huge stroke, but we've just reached hypersonic speeds, everybody. Welcome back to Swiss Missouri 1. But yeah, great physics here. I mean, again, there is an F-35 for the X-Plane Flight Simulator, which is a lot better. I mean, I made a video about that one, too. What's up, the one?
The one 6,927 donated 16 Hong Kong dollars. Your physics teacher is crying.
Dude, literally, not only my physics teacher, literally every physicist ever lived. I mean, Isaac Newton is probably going to be crying right now, just about this artificial horizon right here, which makes no sense at all. All right, let's go ahead and leave the stage of hypersonicness. Let me try to come in for a we're leaving it nicely. Let me try to come in for a bit of a landing right here. We've got a runway here on the left of us. Let's maybe try to get that plane here now without the vertical flying mode landed. Maybe do a nice landing for once, because literally, this whole thing is pretty much broken. Let me try. What's up, Subby? Welcome back. Let's maybe try this here. 250 knots. We're coming down a little bit here on the speed. I do want to, like, do a proper landing. I mean, the video is a little bit, like, this whole stream is a little bit flawed when it comes to the flying. I mean, the plane crashed literally on the runway here, the whole flight simulator, so which left us waiting for, like, 20 minutes for the flight simulator to restart, which is interesting. But let's maybe try this here again. We've got this beautiful runway down here. Try to come in for a landing now again without this vertical mode, because I guess that's gonna, you know, work a little bit better. Good. Let's go ahead and get rid of some speed right here. 180 knots. I think that could be fine for the plane. I have no idea how to fly this. We're just gonna kind of. Well, I'm a little bit amazed how we haven't really crashed it. What's up, Killian?
Killian Nem donated €2. Moin aus Rheinland-Pfalz-Reward dein Tag bei Sche.
Good. I just woke up. So there was not much day to live. It was regular Sunday. Even though it's almost 3 in the afternoon. Okay, let's land. Okay, that hasn't been a very butter landing. So let me try to see. How fast does this plane stop? Oh, goodness. We're not stopping very quickly, are we? Oh, stop, you stupid airplane. We have no reverse thrust, of course. Oh, we're in the grass. We're doomed. Oh, are we? All right, that was only a minor overrun. Let's maybe see. We have a, oh, no. Three-play mode. The thing is, the replay mode only recorded, like, literally before we landed. So we don't have the landing here in the replay mode. Oh, come on. Maybe we try to do this landing again so that we have a replay at least. All right, never mind. We just crashed a $100 million airplane. Welcome back to Professionally Flying with Swiss Missouri 1. Let me try to do this landing again. I do want to have, like, a landing at least replayed once, just like we always have. We always have landings to replay, so, you know what? That could be fun. Let's go ahead and give it a little bit more speed. You know what? I like flying fighter jets, though. I mean, this the F-35 kind of sucks, again, because it's a little bit flawed as an add-on plane. But you know what? This is a lot of fun. I like how reactive this jet is, right? Very nicely flyable. Also, again, how the plane just taxis as well. All right, let's maybe try to do this again. Proper landing. Oh, runway, come on. All right, that's been a landing. A little bit smooth. You know what? Fine. But it's now time to stop. Of course, again, no reverse thrust. All right. What's that, butter? Let's go ahead and see. And it's still the thing. You know, I always talk about these butter landings, right? But I'm literally the one who's still not... having installed a monitor, like a landing rate monitor or anything like that. You know, too fast. Yeah, I'm not quite sure about the approaching speeds of like the F-18, but there we go. That's been a nice landing, you guys. What do you guys think? That's been fine. You guys are just always hating on my landings, but that's been all right, I think. Has this been all right? Yeah, this has been all right. Stop hating. You guys just keep hating on By the way, I like how the multiplayer is just completely crazy at this point, but that's just another normal Swiss is there one flight. What I want to do now is, of course, a vertical takeoff. Let's do that. Good. Stovel mode. Yes, everybody. Good. That has been a good takeoff. You know, this is what I like about the F-35. What I don't like is this again. Why does the plane turn to the right? I'm letting go of the controls, and the plane's just banking to the right until it's in the state of literally Australia, literally being upside down, but it still continues to fly because the physics are just broken. What a great simulation right there. Why is this not working properly? I don't get it. Makes no sense. But that's just great to see. Because of a broken wing. Is it that realistic, this add-on? I wouldn't trust it to be that realistic. I mean, it does perfectly work in this normal flying mode. Let's go back to the normal flying. Here we go. No problem here at all. Flies perfectly straight. Nothing wrong here. I don't really get the physics. It's just broken, this airplane. But yeah, that's just great to see. Let me continue now to the next airport. What do you got? LFMHM. I remember that airport is quite a bit of a bigger one. Let's go ahead and cheat ourselves there. I mean, the thing is, we don't even normally have to use the slew mode in this plane. That's like a good thing. This plane is so fast, it doesn't matter. What's up, Steven? How's it going, Steven? What you got to say?
Steven1234 donated $3. Ryanair Butter Landing.
Take that back. Don't want to... I don't ever want to hear Ryanair... The word Reiner and the word butter in the same sentence, because that's a violation. Good. Let's maybe go back to now flying this airplane. We've got, I think this is now Megève Airport. We've come now from, I don't know what airport's... Somewhere in the French Alpine Mountains. It doesn't matter. We've got Megève Airport. I think that's what it's called again. Let's go ahead and land this airplane now down there. We might just want to try out this vertical mode. Which doesn't work. Plane turns to the right very much again. All right, then no vertical mode. My God, why is this broken? All right, come on. A little bit of speed here. Got the nice runway. You know what? This plane actually can fly at some shorter runways than I thought. I mean, of course, it can fly an aircraft carrier, so it must be able to deal with some short stuff.
Robert, who donated 2 Swiss francs. Hey,
a bit of a hard
one. I am a huge fan. You deserve this, Dono.
Thank you very much, dude. There we go, by the way, we've just landed this jet here. This plane actually does not have any issues with short runways at all. And I didn't record this on the replay mode. My God, I cannot wait to be streaming again with X-Plane. Great. Good. Now, time to take off again. What a professional flight today, isn't it? Good. Runway, let's go ahead and take off again. Beautiful. You know what? This plane has some good runway performance, doesn't it? What's up, Subby?
Sub again. 124 or donated
sub,
2
what
euros.
Doesn't matter.
Jetzt heißt weg. Wann bist du denn schlafen gegangen?
You guys just keep donating in German, don't you? I went to sleep at not all that late, I think 2 in the morning, but I'm just a little bit wasted currently because of the I got the booster vaccination on Thursday. I think it was Thursday. And so I'm a little bit, you know, there are some side effects when you get freshly boosted, I think, especially at a younger age. What was that? What did the woman just say? I didn't hear that. Help. I'm in confusion. But yeah, anyway, there are some side effects to having a booster vaccination. So I'm a little bit mentally, like, not at my most fagalicious. Is that even a word? Anyway, we've got some runways to land on. Let's maybe go to top speed. Maybe see how fast we can go. We're at Mach 1.2. That's great. Ba-da-ba-boom. By the way, how badly do you guys want me to make a channel in German while we're at the topic? Because there are a lot of German donations here today for some reason. The woman said 12, did she? Why would she say 12? I don't really get this plane sometimes. It's a very beautiful model, though. I just want to mention that. Not very realistic. Also, Why are we... Guys, I have a feeling that we've run out of fuel, actually. All right, everybody, welcome back to Dealing with an Emergency.
$3.21. I should ski now, but I got COVID.
Oh. Well, get well soon. Well, that sucks. We're probably all going to get it now with the Omicron. So don't worry about it. I'm hoping that you have no symptoms at all. So yes, everybody, welcome back to Swiss is 01. We have had now an emergency. We are having an emergency indeed. I have no control. I have zero control of this airplane. What's up, Yono? No, if you're going to crash now, you have crashed. Oh my God. You have to be kidding me. What are we supposed to do now? What should we do now? Sub Subby. What should we do now?
Sub 124 donated €3. 2. Du bist noch jung, du brauchst viel Schlaf. Smiley face.
Alright. We've been streaming now for an hour. Guess how many times? Guess how many times this thing crashed?
Martix donated $2.33. Swiss bruh. I told you not to use Afterburner and X-Plane version.
I know. Okay, well, a little bit of a sip, right? What happened here was we ran out of fuel, and I was about to do a perfect emergency landing. No Trevor Jacob kind of jumping out of the aeroplane kind of thing. No. Everything was looking professional. Everything was looking good. Everything was looking perfect. But then the whole plane just decided to die. Crash. You know, nice little freeze screen right there, and then the crash to the desktop. And I know restarting the flight simulator now would take too long. And I do understand very much. I have another 1-star ratings. I mean, the plane isn't bad. I mean, there are some physics problems. Let's, you know, forget about that. Constant CTDs, right? Constant CTDs, desktop PC. Christian, CTD. Ellery. All right, Ellery doesn't say anything about the CTDs. But there's a lot of crashes here. Bernhardt, Contra, flight model needs. Okay, I do understand that. CTD after 10 minutes of every flight. This was going to be a very professional flight. I mean, could you guys see how professionally I flew this plane? I mean, I did run out of fuel. But we're going to forget about that, you know, once we think about other people that have crashed their planes intentionally in real life. Why are these ratings here so good? Crashes for me too about 5 minutes later. Only crashes. Welcome back to Swiss 001. But yeah, this is a great plane. So this is sad. So, by the way, should we keep streaming? Should we try flying the F-35 in the X-plane? You know what? I honestly don't feel like we're done with streaming. Let's try to fly the X-plane F-35, because that's actually a great one. You know what? Let's maybe make a longer stream today. I've got some time on my hands. You guys have got some time to try the F-35 and the X-plane flight simulator? Should we try the... Okay. All right. Let's have a bit of a comparison right here. All right, here we go. What I like about X-Plane, by the way, I mean, you know what? What's funny is that I've always complained about the startup times of X-Plane until Microsoft Flight Simulator was released. Because literally, in comparison, the X-Plane Flight Simulator is quite a dream. All right, so new flight. Let's go ahead and try F-35. We have it right here. Very nice add-on. Wait, let me just check this out. Do I still have it? Yes. Look how many F-35s we have. Let's just spawn also again into the F-35B here, which also have a VTOL flight. My God. This is literally the ugliest livery I've ever seen in my entire life. All right, where should we go? Let's go to, where should we go? Le Mall Airport could be an option. Not quite sure today. Where should we go? I mean, okay, let's maybe try Le Mall indeed. All right, let's spawn in there. Maybe try to fly the spawn. What's up, Martix?
Martix donated $2.10. Yes, now I can finally help you with HUD and other stuff.
Mm-hmm. Literally. The thing is, yeah, X-Plane never crashed. Okay, X-Plane does like to crash sometimes the flight simulator, but it's not that bad. It's not as bad, especially as the flight simulator Microsoft. All right, so let's go. Oh, you should have gone to St. Bartholomew. Oh my God, yes, I should have. Can we go back? Never mind, I have one idea. I'm just gonna wait for it to spawn into Le Mall. Again, the loading times are a little bit, you know, bad. But it's not as bad as Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020, so we're still saving time out here. I just want to show you one thing. One thing only that the X-Plane model, the X-Plane F-35 has, which, of course, the Flight Simulator model, the MSFS, doesn't have. Wait a second. Come on. It's going to take a bit of a while. You know, while we're just waiting out here for it to load, I'm still looking for video ideas. I technically have to record 3 videos today. One video is going to be about the Track IR thing. I need 2 more video ideas. Please. I need one. I'm kind of dry when it comes to those today. So we're just waiting out here. Come on! BeamNG. Oh, I've done like 1,000 videos on BeamNG. It hasn't become a little bit boring. Come on! Load! Why isn't it loading? Done with preloading. Okay, you know what? I'll take that back, the part where I said the X-Plane waiting times are better than the Microsoft waiting times, because it's not much better, is it? As you can tell, it's taking longer than I expected. When is it loading? Done with preloading. What does that even mean? What is preloading? Ah, there we go. Oh, X-Plane licensing. Please remove or update plugin. Uh-oh. Okay. See, I haven't played X-Plane in a while, and you can probably tell. All right, let's get rid of this weird blur add-on. Wait a second. Plugin admin. ShadeX. Turn it off. Good. Welcome back to Buzz 01. All right, let's go. All right. We're on board the F-35 again. What's up, Anton? Aus Tirol. Let's go ahead and how do we close the canopy, first of all? That's probably important. Canopy? Where? Welcome back to Supposed to Desert One. All right, let's go ahead and sit down right here. Good. Everything is fine. Now, this plane, this is from like A2A, AOA simulations. This is, you know, it does look a little bit uglier, but it's a lot better. So let's go ahead and turn this on right here. Good. I don't know what that even does. Let me turn off the lights. We've got a few more. What's up, Alec? Good. Now.
Alec Bajczyk donated $3. There we go. Swiss 01 DCS fund.
Should we play these DCS? How do I close the canopy? Do I do this with a menu here? Help. Oh, this plane is a little bit confusing, honestly. Okay, anyway, let's maybe try to start up the engine already. How does it? All right, engine start. Yes. Good. Give it some power. Come on. Good. Looking good. Or something like that. Perfect. Hello, plane. Turn on! By the way, well, something that we do have here, by the way, is weapons. I just wanted to mention that as well. Also, there are some pre-flight things that have to be undone. How do I do this? My God, this plane's a little bit more confusing than I thought. This is now the autopilot menu. What does this even do, all those things here? We can have this eject button, by the way. Just wanted to mention that as well. We're not going to press that just yet. HMD, help! How do I do this? ATR, APC. I'm confusion. How do I turn on this aeroplane? How do I get everything ready here? Learn the plane. Now. Okay. Looking. Oh, there we go. Close the canopy. Good. Let's go ahead and. How do we turn on this plane now?
Tyler donated $500. Donated $25.
You got this me there. Work. Seriously, dude. Oh my god. Tyler, do not ever do this again. I just almost died inside. Can we start the airplane, please? My god, you got me there, dude. You got me there. Definitely. I just almost died inside. Press Control E. Oh, it's not the right one. Ah! Help! Come on, plane, turn on. Well, how do I get rid of these remove before flight stickers? How do I do this plane? This is the camera, I guess. Help! IFR. What does that even do here? Guys! Help me get this plane ready. I'm just overwhelmed with this. ATR, APC, what does that even do? I have no idea what is this about. This is, I guess, for the VTOL mode, but other than that, how do I get the plane ready? How do I get rid of the stuff here? Like this here. Where the hell is the menu where I can set this up? Help! How do I get rid of this? You know what? I have an option here. How about we press the eject seat? Look at this! Look at this nice simulation. Good. Look at this. We've just done the ejection. Isn't this awesome? All right, let's maybe spawn here on an approach here with the engines running, because otherwise this is never going to work, this flight. My god, I don't know why. I tried starting the engines, like pressing the ignition switch a few times. It didn't work because, again, I hadn't done the pre-flight, so that didn't work. You can switch to the other one. What's up, Vercrafted HD?
Vercraft at HD donated $2.28. Du kannst schon mal Airport CEO spielen, de Batman seinen eigenen Flughafen. Alternativ könntest du schon mal wieder Teardown spielen.
Oh, Teardown is another idea. Are there any more good add-ons for Teardown, though? I don't think so. But yeah, welcome back to Swiss01. This is a great stream. Nothing is really working here. All the flight simulators are just basically broken. But this is just great to see. This is just great. All right, everybody. Welcome to the south of France. Finally, this is working. All right. So we've got some weapons here. Can we shoot them? Probably not. Where's my shooting button? We have none. Great to see. What's up, Tyler?
Tyler donated $500. Again, huh? Donated $25. I have confidence I will be on Swiss 002.
No. No, you won't. You won't. What's up, Dev? By the way, can we just have a bit of a listen to the beautiful sound of this aeroplane? Oh!
Multix donated $2.10. You need to hold the ignition switch for a while and then try to the BRT under the display.
Oh. Alright, let's maybe try the BRT now. Oh! Nice! I wouldn't hear this again.
Terrain.
And on that note, it is time to end the stream. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been a very successful stream. Yeah, you know, actually the flight simulator model of the F-35 flew very well, but the X-plane flight simulator model is a little bit more professional, I can tell, and it does require a little bit more preparation, so I'm not really able to fly this. Very nice video, very nice stream. Thank you for your ears, and I'll see you guys in tomorrow's stream. Or maybe, you know what, maybe I'm gonna stream later on today as well. We'll see you guys in that one. As always, good night. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Very appreciated.